Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. This video will guide you to get started with deep learning. Let's take a look at the topics we'll cover in this video. First, we'll talk about what deep learning is. Next, we'll discuss what the differences are between deep learning and machine learning. After that, we'll handle important deep learning algorithms. And then, we'll see frameworks used for deep learning. Next, we'll take a look at fields you need to know for deep learning. Finally, we'll go through awesome resources to learn deep learning. Let's get started with what deep learning is. Deep learning is a machine learning technique and is used to find hidden patterns in big data. It is based on the artificial neural network algorithm, which is a machine learning technique. ANNs consist of one hidden layer, while deep neural networks consist of more than one hidden layer. Okay, we briefly talked about what deep learning is. Let's move on to what is the difference between machine learning and deep learning. Although deep learning is seen as a subfield of machine learning, there are some differences between them. Let's take a look at these differences. Machine learning is often used for structured data in tabular form, while deep learning is generally used for unstructured data such as images, videos, and text. Machine learning is used for small and medium datasets, while deep learning is used for analyzing big data. While machine learning analysis takes a short time, deep learning analysis can sometimes take days or weeks. Machine learning is generally used for tasks such as classification, regression, and clustering, while deep learning is mostly used for tasks such as image and NLP. While machine learning projects can be performed with a simple computer, powerful computers are required for deep learning projects. Cool, we have looked at the differences between machine learning and deep learning. Let's move on to deep learning algorithms. Deep learning is more like art than science. You can obtain great models if you build the right architecture for your project. Let's look at important algorithms used in deep learning. CNN architecture has revolutionized image processing. Thanks to this algorithm, computers gained human-level vision. This architecture uses filters and layers to extract patterns in images. Because of this way of working, this architecture is often used for the classification of images, recognition of objects, face recognition, and similar applications. CNNs performed well for image processing, but not for NLP tasks such as translation. The RNN architecture was developed for data where patterns change over time, such as NLP and time series. RNN store historical data in memory and use this data to predict the next data. Another groundbreaking deep learning algorithm is GANs, which is used for increasing production, especially in fields such as art and video games. GANs are frequently used to generate data in areas such as image and NLP. For example, with GANs, you can generate photographs or realistic human speeches. Today, there is a huge amount of data. It is very difficult to extract information from big data because it contains so many features. To reduce the dimension of big data, you can use autoencoders. Autoencoders learn a compressed representation of the data and enable processing on less dimensional data. For example, consider a thick book. You want to describe this book in just a few sentences. This is where autoencoders come in. Transformers is a deep learning architecture designed for NLP applications. This architecture reveals the meaning of the text by performing mathematical calculations and deals with different aspects of the text using many attention mechanisms. It worked great on architectural translation tasks. State-of-the-art models such as GPT and BERT were developed using the Transformers architecture. There are many more deep learning algorithms. In this section, we discussed the most important ones. Let's look at the application areas of deep learning now. Deep learning is a technique that increases the ability of computers to learn and make decisions. This technique has many different applications. Let's take a look at some applications where deep learning techniques are used. Thanks to deep learning techniques, a computer can recognize objects in a picture and classify these objects correctly. For example, you can use deep learning in projects such as image classification, object detection, face recognition, and image restoration. Another area where deep learning is used a lot is NLP. For example, you can use deep learning in projects such as translation, text classification, text generation, and sentiment analysis. The most popular application of deep learning in NLP recently is ChatGPT. This chatbot showed everyone what AI tools can do. There is no limit to what you can do with deep learning. Especially lately, deep learning techniques are used very often for speech processing. Speeches can be generated from your 3-second voice. You can also use deep learning in many speech processing projects, such as speech recognition, speech synthesis, and music analysis. Deep learning also has many applications in the healthcare field. For example, you can use deep learning to diagnose diseases, produce medicines, and carry out health analytics. Another use of deep learning is automation. With this technique, you can make projects in areas such as robotics and automatic control systems. You can also use deep learning in finance. For example, you can use this technique for topics such as financial risk analysis, portfolio management, and credit risk prediction. Deep learning has many uses, but lastly, let's look at agriculture. You can use deep learning for projects such as detecting plant diseases and classifying and predicting crops. Nice, we covered some applications of deep learning. Let's dive into the frameworks you can use to build deep learning projects. Deep learning analysis requires intense mathematical operations. It is very difficult to perform these operations manually. Fortunately, great libraries have been developed recently to carry out deep learning projects. With these frameworks, you can train awesome deep learning models and monitor the performance of these models. Let's take a look at these frameworks. The most used library is TensorFlow, developed by Google. With TensorFlow, you can build end-to-end deep learning projects. This means that you can perform data pre-processing, modeling, and put the model into production with this framework. TensorFlow can be used with different programming languages such as Python, C++, and Java. Another library we will go through is Keras. Keras was previously a library that worked on different frameworks, but it married TensorFlow in 2019. It is a high-level API in TensorFlow that even non-AI experts can easily carry out deep learning projects. Another open-source framework for deep learning is PyTorch. PyTorch is an open-source deep learning framework developed by Facebook. This framework quickly became popular because it was easy and flexible. In industry, TensorFlow is mostly used, while PyTorch is often used for academic research. The last framework we're going to talk about is Hugging Face. Hugging Face is an open-source platform for NLP applications. Hugging Face aims to be the GitHub for data scientists. Within this framework, you can find both pre-trained model S and many datasets. Train your model with the Transformers library in Hugging Face and put these models into production with the Gradio library in your own space. Voila! You can also use it in your computer vision projects with the recently developed the Diffusers library. Cool, we've seen the most used frameworks for deep learning. Let's take a brief look at which areas you need to know to perform deep learning projects. Deep learning is an interdisciplinary area consisting of several fields. Don't worry, you just need to know these areas at a basic level. There are three main pillars of deep learning. These are applied mathematics, computer science, and domain-specific knowledge. Let's go through these areas. Applied mathematics includes, in particular, linear algebra, probability, and statistics. Linear algebra is a fundamental area, as deep learning models are based on matrix computations. Probability is used to understand probability distributions of data. Deep learning models predict probability distributions of data. So, it is important to know probability theory for deep learning. Another important area for deep learning is statistics. Statistics is a field used to analyze, explore, and summarize data. Techniques such as mean, standard deviation, data standardization, regularization, and metrics are frequently used in deep learning projects. So knowing fundamental statistical techniques helps you build better deep learning models. Another pillar of deep learning is computer science. For deep learning, you need to learn a programming language. The most used programming language is Python. Since Python's language is easy, many libraries are written in this language. You also need to know parallel programming techniques to carry out your deep learning analyses faster. Another field you need to know for deep learning is domain knowledge. Big data is very important for deep learning. To build a good deep learning model, you need to understand and interpret data related to the field you are working on. Don't worry if you don't gain insight into the dataset. You can get help from an expert in the field for this. Nice, we briefly talked about the important areas for deep learning. Finally, let's move on to resource recommendations for deep learning. Everyone has a different way of learning a field. Some like to learn by watching videos, and some by reading. I love to learn both by watching and reading. There are many resources for deep learning, both video and written. I'm trying to collect these resources on our GitHub page called Resources for Data Science. In this section, I'd like to talk about the books that I love to read. The first book I would recommend for deep learning is Hands-on Machine Learning. When asked for a book recommendation for deep learning, this book usually comes to mind first. This book consists of two parts. In the first part, Machine Learning with Scikit-learn, and in the second part, Deep Learning with TensorFlow and Keras. It is one of the rare books that combines theory and practice. Another book I would recommend is Deep Learning with Python. This book is truly a legendary book for deep learning. This book was written by the developer of Keras. This book is great to learn the basics of deep learning with examples. The third book I'd recommend is AI and Machine Learning for Coders. I think you'll read this book without getting bored. The book begins by teaching direct AI techniques with TensorFlow. It teaches deep learning with step-by-step applications. If you're new to areas like computer vision, NLP, and time series, this book is for you. This book also explains the TensorFlow ecosystem very well. The three books I mentioned above describe deep learning with TensorFlow and Keras. Let's take a look at another awesome book written using PyTorch. The book I'm talking about is Python Machine Learning. This book consists of two parts. In the first part, machine learning algorithms with Scikit-learn are explained. The second part demonstrates deep learning techniques with PyTorch. Deep learning is an exciting field. AI tools such as ChatGPT are developed with deep learning techniques. In this video, we explored what you need to know about deep learning in 7 steps. You learned the differences between deep learning and machine learning, important algorithms, application areas, frameworks, and fields you need to know for building deep learning models. You also saw excellent books to get started in deep learning. The best way to learn is by doing. To master deep learning, you must practice a lot with real-world datasets. That's it. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy it. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon, so you don't miss the latest content about AI and data science. You can also follow us on other social media accounts. See you in the next video. Bye for now.